read somewhere that you talk about this career ladder, where the first stage in this career ladder is where you're an individual contributor, you're just executing. The next stage is when you are teaching others to execute, and then you teach others who can teach others and more people how to execute.
Yes.
And finally, you have the stage where you call to the beach. Where do you find yourself right now? How has your journey been?
I'm still doing a bit of each, really, because when I do direct training, I'm teaching 20 people something, and that's it. So I'm just doing it. I did try managing a bunch of trainers, by the way, but I found that quite unsatisfying. You could have 10 trainers working for you, and you could keep 10% of the money of each. But I found that was a full-time job, and I would rather just do the training. So I didn't find management very satisfying. But coaching people to be trainers, and then off they go, and they can just do it. That is really satisfying. I like that. And I like the fact as well that there's an incentive for them to do it. If you're just training a group of people who maybe have been sent by their boss, they don't have to even listen, or they may listen, but they may never do it. Whereas if you're actually coaching somebody and training is going to be their career, they're really, really interested in learning it. So I think you can have more effect if you teach other people how to do things rather than doing it yourself. You can make more of a difference in the end. And what drives me actually is making a difference. So I love the thought that a million people have watched my project management course online, because I'm thinking, even if one person in a thousand only, if only one in a thousand actually does everything I've told them, out of a million people, that's still a thousand people out there who are doing perfect projects. So I love the fact that I've probably helped. And if they, maybe they do, perhaps they do five projects over the coming years. That's 5,000 projects that have been done really well. And some of those might be irrigation projects in Africa or something. They might be feeding hundreds of thousands of people or something like that. So what drives me is making a difference. And I like the idea I can make a video, stick it online, and lots of people will view it. And I also like the idea that I can train somebody else how to be a trainer, and they can go off and change lots of people's lives. So I think I'm at the point where I'm making quite a difference to people. And I really like that. And I don't really want to go to the point where I just sit on a beach and don't do anything anymore. Even though my videos would still be out there, I think the problem is I keep having more ideas. And when I go on holiday, I sit on the beach and I suddenly think of, oh, actually, that's a really interesting time management theory that I've thought of. So then I want to write it and stick it out there. So I think because I keep having ideas, I want to keep working. I don't want to retire. I think I'd be bored just sitting on a beach. I quite like to spend 1 week per month on a beach, go on holiday quite a lot, but keep working. And if you're self-employed, you can do that, of course, because if you're self-employed, nobody's counting your holiday days. Imagine going back to a world where somebody says, sorry, Chris, you've had 20 days off this year. You've now got to work solidly for the whole rest of the year. That would be awful. So if you're self-employed, you can work for 3 weeks and have a week on the beach. That's what I want to do. I don't want to be permanently on the beach. I think I would get bored.
I think that deserves a blog post on its own. I think you should talk about the new career ladder, where it's not a straight up ladder. It goes up and down like a roller coaster.